Reproduction in genus Vaucheria of Xanthophysae can happen vegetatively, asexually, or sexually. Vegetative method is by means of fragmentation. The method of asexual reproduction varies depending upon the habitat in which the algae occurs. The common methods of asexual reproduction is zoospore formation, aplanospore formation, and acaenates formation. Sexual reproduction in all species of genus Vaucheria is of oogamous type. As earlier stated, fragmentation is a method of vegetative reproduction in Vaucheria. During fragmentation, the thallus accidentally breaks up into small fragments. Each of these fragments become decoiled, and from each fragment, new thallus will develop. However, this mode of vegetative reproduction is not common in the genus Vaucheria.
Zoospores are motile spores produced in Vaucheria during asexual reproduction. Commonly, aquatic species of Vaucheria reproduces asexually by this method. Zoospore formation in aquatic members is favored by conditions like low light intensity, low concentration of nutrients in the medium, conversion of running water to still water, etc. In Vaucheria, these zoospores are formed in specialized sac-like structures called zoosporangium.
The zoosporangium is formed at the tip of a side branch in the thallus. At the time of zoosporangium formation, the tip of the branch gets swollen and develop into a club-shaped structure. Accumulation of cytoplasm along with a large number of nuclei and chromatophores occur at this swollen tip. Now, a transverse septum is formed, which separates the swollen tip from rest of the synostitic thallus. Then, the swollen tip acts as the zoosporangium and is with a deep green color. At the initial stage, the nuclei are in the center and chromatophores are arranged in the periphery like that of main thallus. Then, the nuclei in the young zoosporangium move from center to the periphery and chromatophores move from periphery to the center. Later, entire protoplast of the zoosporangium contracts and forms single zoospore. Mature zoospores are liberated through an opening at the distal end of the zoosporangium. Opening is formed by the gelatinization of sporangial wall, and the liberation of zoospores usually occur at the early morning.
Mature zoospores are oval in shape and are with a yellow-green color. These zoospores are with a plasma membrane externally, and at the center we can see a soft vacuole. The region between this membrane and vacuole is cytoplasm of zoospore. This cytoplasm is with an outermost hyaline region. In this hyaline or translucent region, we can see numerous nuclei. Each of these nuclei is associated with a pair of centrioles, and from each pair of centrioles, a pair of flagella are arised. And this flagella act as the locomotive organ of zoospore. Internally, the cytoplasm is with numerous chromatophores and contractile vacuoles. The zoospores of Vaucheria are commonly called as syn-zoospore or syno-zoospore due to their multinucleate and multiflagellate condition. It is supposed that this type of zoospore is formed due to failure of division of zoosporangium protoplast to uninucleate and biflagellate zoospore.
Just after liberation, the multiflagellate zoospore will show a sluggish movement for about 5 to 15 minutes. After that, they came to rest. During this time, they lose their flagella and become round off. Then a thin cellulosic wall will be deposited over the zoospore. Later, one or two tubular outgrowths will develop from the zoospore. From one of the tubular outgrowths, colorless rhizoidal region will develop, and the other grow to an yellowish green thallus.